Good morning, dear student. In last session, we saw how narration was modified in the form of direct and indirect speech. We also saw how the part in which verbs with the subject, with the reporter, that is called reporting verb or reporting clause, and the part in which there is inverted comma, it is called reported speech, because in which there is the speech of the reporter, of the subject, of the speaker, that we change it in our own words. Now, we are going to continue it with changing in tense. Changing in tense. Last day we saw changing in person. Last day we saw changing in the word related to adverb. Now, dear children, try to be concentrated again, because this tense is the vital part. This tense is the vital part for the whole English grammar. Not only grammar, in writing section you will have to take the help of tense. So here we are going to see the rules. First of all, you all know the tense that has three parts. Number one is present tense, number two is past tense, number three is future tense. So, present, past and future. Here, the rule that I am going to teach you, in that rule, we will see present and future. We will see present and future at first. So, listen carefully, I am going to deliver the rule. The rule is, if the tense of the verb, here this is tense of the verb, if the tense of the verb, reporting verb, this is called reporting verb, if the tense of the verb is in present tense or in future tense. Listen carefully. The rule is, if the tense, here tense of the verb is present, tense of the verb is future. Here it is present, here it is future. Again I repeat, the third time I am going to repeat it. If the tense of the verb of reporting clause is in present, either present or future, the tense of reported speech will not change. The tense of the verb of reported speech, the tense of the verb of reported speech will remain same. An example, here it is present, so this will present. Here it is future, so because here it is present, so there it is will be present. Now we change it. Now we are going to change it according to this rule. What is it? G. Last time I told you, change to or say to is equal to tell or tells. Last day I told you, says to or say to is equal to tell. I told you. So here this says to will be tells. So he tells me. Now last day we saw comma will be changed into the conjunction that. Comma will be changed into conjunction that. Now, come on, sum formula. Just remind, रिमाइंडेशन फॉर्मूला, आई टोल्ड यू लास्ट डे दैट इफ द पर्सन ऑफ फर्स्ट पर्सन ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट द पर्सन ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ रिपोर्टेड स्पीच इज इन सेकेंड पर्सन, इज इन सेकेंड पर्सन इट विल बी अकॉर्डिंग टू द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ We saw this was the second part of Sanpanna. So now it will be you. So he tells me that I, because here me is object, me will be changed into subject I. So here I am in present tense with I am used. So I am a good here. We have seen here because it is in present tense, the tense of the verb of the voting verb is in present tense. So here it has been remained in present tense. Now we come the second example. The second example, the tense of the verb of reporting verb or reporting verb is in future. So again there will be no change. So we are going to solve it. I shall tell him again, comma, that. We all know this is changed into that. So that, and again I told you that because it is future, so there will be no change in the tense of the verb of reported speech. So that is now see. Now this is your case. Listen carefully. Your, this is case, this is adjective. So this your, because this is noun. So this becomes adjective. So this adjective, this will be changed according to the object. So here object is him. So I shall tell him that this tab is conjunction and this tab is the changing part of this, that is his. Why his? Because your has been changed according to object, him becomes his. In the last grade table I gave you the description, is his mistake. So this is the first rule. So this first rule, again I am going to sum up. The rule is this, that if the tense of the verb of reporting verb is either in present tense or in future tense, there will be no change in the tense of the verb of reporting speech. Okay, so now we are going towards past tense. We are going towards past tense. Now we see at first one example. I said to him, you play well. Now see, till now in the first rule, we saw it was present or future in reporting verb. Now it is past. So last day I told you said to is equal to told. Said to is equal to told. So here I am going to tell you the second rule. Listen carefully. If the tense of the verb of reporting clause, is in past form, or past tense, whatever you can say, past form, the tense of the verb of reported speech will follow as according. So there are six. There are six steps based on tens. There are six steps based on tens. We will see it. So we will also see the structure of every part which we will take as example of the rule. So here, see, number one is, just pay attention, number one is, if the reported speech is in simple present, if the reported speech is in simple present, it will change into simple past. Simple past. So, at first, you must see what is the structure of simple present. So, see, subject plus V1 or V5 SPS is the structure of simple present. Okay? This is the structure of simple present. So, this simple present will be changed into simple past. So, what is simple past? Subject plus V2. Okay? E recall. Okay? Now, we will change it to see, to justify this first rule. See, I said to, told. I can make it remain also that I said to him, because this is the rule that said to is changed into told. It is why I have written I told him, comma, that. Now, inverted comma will be omitted. Don't forget it. Now, I told him that. So, this you play well was in present, simple present, and we have to transform it in simple past. So, it will be you will be changed according to the object, because it is second person. Never forget it. Some formula, second person will be changed according to object. So, I told him that he, and now play V1, play in V1, play will be V2, play will be V2, so, and you must know, played, it is V5, SPS, okay? So, I told him that he played well, okay? I told him that he played well. Now, I omit this part so that it can be seen clearly. Now, see, we have changed this part, I said to him, you play well, into, I told him that he played well. Now, one thing, you must pay attention. V1 and V5, that is SES. Always remember, because this is basic rule, but sometimes we forget it. V1 is used with I, we, you, and they, and plural subject. While V5 is used with he, she, it, name, and singular subject. Always make yourself prepare for this one thing. V1, I, we, you, they, and plural subject. V5 SES, he, she, it, name, and singular subject. Okay. Now, we are going to our second part. Second rule, we see one example. Ram said, I am playing cricket. Ram said, I am playing cricket. So first we saw simple present change into simple past. Second, this is present continuous. This is present continuous. This is present continuous. So if the tense of the verb, the quoting verb, is in past tense, and when our quoted speech is in present continuous, it will be changed into past continuous. So, what is the structure of present continuous and what is the structure of past continuous? So, present continuous, see, subject plus is, am, are plus before ing. Subject plus is, am, are plus before plus ing. And this will be changed into subject plus was, where plus before ing. Okay, so this is called verb to be. Verb to be. Verb to be. It is it, am, are, was, where. These five verbs come under verb to be. So verb to be. Present verb is, present verb means this. Present verb is used in present continuous and past verb this is used in past continuous. So we have seen verb to be in the way of hearing the changing of this present continuous into past continuous. Now see, Ram said, so already comma takes place of that and inverted comma we change. Now see according to the structure, so Ram said that I. Now see some formula again some formula, remind it. I is in first person. So the first rule of some formula says that if the subject of reported speech, if the subject of reported speech is in first person, it will be according to the subject of reporting verb or reporting clause. So here I according to Ram, and Ram is third person singular number, and it is male. Last time I told you, for male it is he, for female it is she. So it is he. Now we have seen this present has been changed into past. So here past he was. Again see in past you must know that was and were. You must be confirmed regarding it. I, he, she, it, name and singular subject. Was is used. And we, you, they and plural subject, where is used. Always have this idea with you. Okay? So here, because he is third person singular number, so was with he was here playing. So he was playing cricket. So second part we have done. So what happened here? We see we saw that if it is in simple present, it is changed into simple past. Then what we saw? If it is in present continuous, it will be in past continuous. So number one and number two we have seen. Now we are going towards number three. Now we see number three. Example is Ram said to me. Ram said to me, you have done my homework. You have done my homework. Now see the third one. The third one. Again, see, if the verb tense of the verb reporting clause is in past time, or past tense, or past verb, this is present perfect. So, present perfect. Will be changed into past perfect. Present perfect will be changed into past perfect. So see, subject plus had plus V3. Now again come this had. This has I have we have you have they have and plural subject have and has he has she has it has name has and singular subject. So this is basic rule, but we must have already in our mind that I, we, you, they, plural subject, we use have, he, she, it, name, singular subject, we use has. So now, what will be the formula? The formula will be subject plus have plus V3. Now, we change it. Okay? At first, we omit it so that our sentence will be clear. Now, see. Ram told me. Okay? Said to told. No problem. Now, this comma will be changed. Then, that. Okay? Now, you. Second person. Same formula. Dear children, if you have forgotten or if you have not paid attention towards some formula, you will have always problem in the changing of transformation regarding narration, regarding from direct to indirect. So, to transform the direct speech into indirect speech, some formula is essential always. So here, see again. here second person, so second person according to object. So here this will be me object will change into he. So Ram said to me that what it is I, and past is so had done, and now my is first person possessive because this is noun and this is adjective. So my will be according to me, means that I have done. Ram told me that I have done his homework. Okay, here one thing you must be attentive, that having and had, you must pay attention. V1 is had, V2 is had, V3 is had again, so V4 is having, I is for, and V4 SES has. So you must pay attention that these are the five forms of verb of had. Okay? So now we have seen the third part. The third part was this, that if it is in present perfect, it will be changed into past perfect. Okay? Now we are going towards now the fourth one, present perfect continuous will be changed into past perfect continuous. Okay, so here Rajan said, I have been writing a letter. Okay? I have been writing a letter. Now, again, the fourth one, if the tense of the verb, reporting verb or reporting verb in past verb, the tense of the reported speech, if it is present perfect continuous, it will change into past perfect continuous. Okay? So we see. Rajan said that how I wrote, because this comma, it was omitted, then I wrote that. And now this is I, sub formula, first person in subject, so it will be changed according to subject of the reporting clause. So Rajan is third person male, so it will be he. So he, and V2 of having had, so it will be he had been writing a letter. So what we have seen? We have seen that present perfect continuous will change into past perfect continuous. Okay? So now we have gone through four rules. We have gone through four rules of changing if the tense of the verb in reporting clause is past. Now we see fifth one. Okay? if it is simple past. Okay, so he said to me, he said to me, you performed well in the exam. You performed well in the exam. Now see, here the fifth one, this is in simple past. This is in simple past, means subject plus V2. So this simple past, okay, will be changed into past perfect. Into past perfect. Past perfect means subject plus had plus V3. Okay? Now see. He told, said to me that. That has been for comma. Now again, inverted comma. Okay. You, this is second person. So according to object, means I. And now, subject plus had plus V3. So I had performed well in the exam. Okay? So this simple past changed into past perfect. So now we saw simple past into past perfect. Ram said to me, I was teaching them yesterday. I was teaching them yesterday. Okay? Now, we see the last rule of tense best sentence. Ram said to me, I was teaching. What is this? This is past continuous. This is past continuous. Is the mean subject plus was were before ing. So this is subject plus was were plus before. Now we see how it will change into past perfect, past continuous into past perfect continuous. Ram told me, comma, that. Now I, according to Ram, I is first person, so it is according to subject. So that he, now past perfect continuous, so he had been teaching them yesterday, last day in the table of Albert we saw yesterday, the previous day. Okay, so we have seen now past continuous will be changed into past perfect continuous. Now, one thing more. You must know one thing more. Now see, we have seen simple present, we have seen present continuous, we have seen present perfect continuous, simple past and past continuous. So, the remaining two, past perfect or past perfect continuous, no change. Means remain same. So if the reporting verb is in past form, and if in that condition the tense of the reported speech is either in past perfect or in past perfect tense, there will be no change. It will be same, remain same. Now, till now, we have seen the tense-based structure of the sentence. Now see, shall will be changed into should, will be changed into would, can will be changed into could, may will be changed into might, is and will be changed into was, are will be changed into were, do does will be changed into did. So, last day we saw the basic rules of narration, and today we saw the assertive sentence we saw today. Number one, assertive sentence means Especially affirmative. We saw, because negative not will be changing. You not, so I have not taken the example of not, because assertive takes two part, affirmative and negative. Both become assertive. That is also called a statement. So today I have taught you only one part, that is assertive, especially affirmative, and this was these six parts and these part and these part we have done. Next day we will see universal truth, as well as we will go towards interrogative sentence. Thank you. Have a good day.